In this week's headlines, I present to you a quantum tornado that supposedly has something to do with black holes. Do they just put the word quantum in front of everything now? No, it's actually a pretty good description. Let's have a look. The headlines are about a new experiment at the University of Nottingham. They used superfluid helium at just a few degrees above absolute zero to simulate quantum effects nearby a rotating black hole. Is this just their idea of fun? Probably, but they had another reason. It's the best way we know to find out how quantum physics works near a real black hole. This quantum simulation of a black hole might sound similar to the infamous headlines of last year about a wormhole in a quantum computer, but it's very different. The wormhole stuff wasn't just a simulation, it was a simulation of a mathematical duality. For this, you first have to reformulate the mathematics and then you simulate that. But because of this mathematical reformulation, the simulation itself doesn't physically resemble the real thing. So there wasn't anything like a wormhole in the quantum computer. A direct simulation, on the other hand, is like this wind tunnel to test aircraft. It's a physical model of the real thing, but one that can more easily be controlled and measured. The new experiment now is a direct simulation, much like the wind tunnel. Of course, they don't create a real black hole either. That'd require even more pressure than nuclear fusion. Instead, they create what's called an acoustic black hole from which sound can't escape. The flow of the superfluid simulates the curved space-time around the black hole, and then they want to measure what the sound does. Though I must add that what physicists mean by sound isn't exactly Beethoven's symphonies. They just mean there are perturbations traveling in the medium like sound travels in air. And since they use a superfluid, the sound has quantum effects, so it's sound quanta that they're after. This analogy between superfluids and black holes isn't just words. The equations are actually the same. This relation is known as analog gravity. The equations are the same provided the medium has a suitable behavior. For one, it needs to be a superfluid and it also needs to flow in a specific way. That's why they need the quantum tornado. Superfluids have been used before to simulate black holes. The most famous work is that by Jeff Steinhauer at Technion in Israel. In 2015, Steinhauer used a condensate of supercooled atoms to simulate a black hole horizon. In this experiment, Steinhauer wanted to test whether black holes emit radiation, as Stephen Hawking predicted. Hawking made this prediction in 1972. He calculated that black holes must have a temperature that's inversely proportional to their mass, and that means they emit light and other particles. Basically, Hawking said that black holes aren't entirely black. Unfortunately, the temperature of real astrophysical black holes is way too small to be measurable. But if Hawking's calculation was right, then the superfluid analogy of black holes should radiate too, because the maths is the same. And Steinhauer found that his black hole simulation indeed confirmed Hawking's prediction. However, Steinhauer's experiment had a big shortcoming. His black hole simulation didn't rotate. In the real world, black holes rotate. That's just because when matter collapses to a black hole, it's very unlikely to not have any angular momentum. Indeed, as I just told you in a recent episode, the black hole in the Milky Way rotates at 60% of what's physically possible. So in this new experiment in Nottingham, they wanted to simulate a black hole which rotates. That's difficult to do because a superfluid doesn't have friction. That's why it's called superfluid. Normally, if you put a fluid into motion, you start swirling it in one place and that'll drag the rest of the fluid along. In a superfluid, that doesn't work because there's no drag. To get a rotation going in a superfluid, you need to create a quantum vortex. This means you need to set the entire fluid into motion very, very carefully so it goes into a state of high energy. angular momentum. That's the quantum version of rotation, basically. And they indeed managed to get it done. For this experiment, they created the biggest ever quantum vortex in a superfluid that was a few millimeters in diameter. You can actually see this by eye. This is what they call the quantum tornado. In the middle of the vortex, there's an empty channel. Then they measure the properties of their quantum tornado and also look at how the sound quanta propagate in it. However, they say that to measure these quanta precisely, which is the eventual goal, they'd have to create a vortex that rotates faster. So basically, more work is needed. But still, this is amazing stuff. Of course, superfluid analogies are still very different from real gravity. Mathematically, the most important difference is that the curved space-time which the fluid mimics is not created by response to matter, as it's the case for a real black hole. Rather, it's created by the experimentalists. Conceptually, the relevant difference is that the fluid's correspondence to a curved space-time breaks down once the experiment starts to resolve the superfluid's atomic structure. Fluids, we know, are made of smaller things. Space-time, for all we presently know, isn't. But how certain are we of this? What if the fluid analogy is more than an analogy? Maybe space-time really behaves like a fluid. Maybe it is a fluid. And if so, the experiments with fluid analogies might reveal how we can find evidence for the substructure of space-time. Everyone has a weakness, and mine is pens. No, not pens. Pens. And this is the most awesome pen I've ever had. This is the Novium Hover Pen Interstellar Edition. It floats in its base and can freely spin thanks to the strong permanent magnets. And not like the thing drops out when you cough, it's really well balanced. But the hover pen doesn't just look good, it's also a pleasure to write with. It flows nicely across the page and it's refillable too. Novium has a variety of these hover pens, but the coolest one is the premium edition of the hover pen, which has a piece of meteorite embedded. Yes, a real meteorite. So there's part of your pen that actually flew through outer space. I found all of the Novium pens masterpieces of design, the perfect combination of art and functionality. If you want one on your desk too, and I just know you want to, or are looking for a gift for your nerdy friend, make sure to use our link in code, which you find in the info below. That'll get you 10% off on all hover pens and free shipping to most countries. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.